things like the ministry that Brother Harding just showed us in Haiti.
Que Dios puede usar el ministerio como el hermano nos dijo.
And people will ask the question, why? Why are you doing this?
Y la gente puede preguntar por qué lo estás haciendo.
And I would hope.
Y yo,
that our answer every time
que nuestra respuesta cada vez
is because Jesus
es porque Jesús
has been good to us.
Ha sido bueno con nosotros.
And we're responding out of His goodness to us.
Estamos respondiendo sobre su gracia sobre nosotros.
To ultimately not only meet the needs of the flesh,
no solamente las necesidades de la carne,
but that we will have built a platform,
pero para crear una plataforma,
to preach the saving gospel of Jesus Christ to our world.
Predicar el evangelio que salva.
It's hard for them,
es duro para ellos,
to believe what we say,
para creer lo que nosotros decimos,
if all we do is say it.
Si solamente lo decimos,
we've got to act.
Tenemos que actuar.
I had another video I was going to show you. My good friend John Wolfram.
Tenía otro video, pero no lo voy a mostrar.
Went to Vietnam.
Fue al país de Vietnam.
He goes there quite often.
Él va muchas veces para allá.
Preaches this gospel to many people.
Él predica este evangelio a muchos.
The communists had come and destroyed a building that was maybe the only Bible school in Vietnam.
Y los comunistas comenzaron a destruir un instituto bíblico
en ese país.
They had beaten
and imprisoned the leaders.
Ellos encarcelaron a los líderes.
And then John got a burden.
Entonces el hermano John tuvo una carga.
He mentioned to us and a few others.
Y él nos dijo a nosotros.
And we responded and contributed.
Y nosotros respondimos.
We didn't send them a lot of money.
Y le enviamos mucha plata.
You don't know it, but we... You gave him $5,000.
Pero no sabes que le diste $5,000.
And the video is the new construction that has now been built in Vietnam for the developing, the training of preachers in Vietnam. So it's doing everything we can to reach the world.
So haciendo todo lo posible para alcanzar.
With that said, we're privileged to have with us David and Jonathan. And I'm not, just so you can rest a little bit, we're going to, when they finish, we're going to take communion together. I'm not going to try and preach this entire message of 5 pages of notes that I have.
No quiero predicarles esas 5 páginas que yo tengo.
But I am.
Pero sí,
going to talk to us about why we should take communion together
sí,
today.
Hablarles de la importancia de
that we have been given a mission in Washington, D.C.
Que nos ha dado una misión.
We cannot, not one of us can do it alone.
No solamente uno lo puede hacer solo.
But together with Jesus Christ,
pero juntos con Jesucristo,
we can do all things.
Sí podemos hacer todas las cosas.
So I'm going to let these young men come and bring a presentation to us, a preaching.
Vamos a traer a estos hombres que vengan y nos prediquen.
I'm glad there's young men that still want to preach the gospel.
Estoy agradecido con jóvenes que todavía quieren predicar.
So Jonathan, I introduce you to Living Hope. So, Living Hope, this is Jonathan.
Yo hablo muy rápido.
We've been preaching East Coast.
Hemos estado predicando en el este.
And we've stopped at a lot of Spanish churches.
Y hemos parado en muchas iglesias hispanas.
And I tend to get excited when I speak.
Y algunas veces voy muy rápido cuando hablo.
And I forget that I have him translating for me.
Algunas veces me olvido que él está traduciendo.
But it's been awesome.
Pero es algo grande.
It's been amazing.
Es algo grande.
Like Pastor said, we came from California.
Como dijo el pastor, venimos de California.
Drove to New York.
Y manejamos hasta Nueva York.
And that was 3 days.
Fue 3 días.
And it was a challenge.
Fue algo difícil.
But God is good.
Pero Dios es bueno.
I think in our first service we saw 70 healings.
En nuestro primer servicio siete personas fueron sanadas.
The Holy Ghost.
Dos personas fueron llenas del Hemos visto a sanidades.
So God is at work.
Dios ha estado trabajando.
And I'm expecting something from God today.
Yo estoy esperando algo de Dios para hoy.
Already God has been here.
Dios ya está aquí.
He's shown up. We've seen someone get the Holy Ghost.
Hemos visto a alguien recibir el Espíritu Santo.
So like brother Stephen said.
Como el hermano estaba diciendo,
God has given us an opportunity to seize.
Dios nos ha dado una oportunidad,
victory,
para tomar victoria.
So it's time for us to seize.
So es tiempo para
tomar. It's time for us to step out in faith.
Es tiempo para sobreponer nuestra fe.
To do something different.
Para hacer algo diferente.
Like he was saying, the Spirit will tell you to run, but you don't want to.
Como el Espíritu le estaba diciendo, no corres, no quieres.
Get out of our comfort zone today.
Es tiempo de salir de nosotros.
And get what God has for us.
Y tomar lo que el Señor tiene
because
para nosotros.
He has a victory for us.
Porque Él tiene una victoria para nosotros.
If we will step out and grab it.
Si solamente vamos y lo agarramos.
If you need the Holy Ghost today, I'm telling you, you will receive it.
Si tú necesitas el Espíritu,
if you need healing, God has healing for you today.
Si tú
you need healing, God is going to give you your miracle. In the name of Jesus.
Dios te quiere dar tu milagro en el nombre de Jesús.
Since I'm not preaching,
no, yo no estoy predicando.
Brother David will. So I don't want to take too much time, but I'm thankful to be here. It's been a blessing and an honor to be in this church. It's a beautiful church. It's not about the building, it's about the body.
Amen.
I see a beautiful body of people here this morning. And I'm just so grateful and honored to be here with Brother Staten. Thank you so much, Brother Staten, and everyone for having us. God bless you.
Let's welcome Brother David. He's going to bring us up.
Amen. Praise God. Hallelujah. Praise God. Hallelujah. Amen. We serve a living God. Hallelujah. If there's somebody that believes that this morning, we serve a living God. So we should give him living praise, living worship. Hallelujah. Oh, Él todavía vive, Él todavía sana, Él todavía restaura, He still heals, He still restores. I don't know if you're excited this morning, but we come to worship God. It's been an honor, it's been a privilege to be here this morning. Ha sido un privilegio, un honor de estar aquí con ustedes en esta mañana. I truly appreciate Brother Staten. He's such a man of God. He was talking to us. Amen. How many of you appreciate your pastor? Such a man of God. He was talking to us at Pizza Hut, and my jaw just dropped. It was crazy. The stories that he was telling us about his experiences, outreach, las historias que nos estaba diciendo. Él estaba evangelizando y ganó muchas almas para Dios. He won many souls to Christ, and it was such a great experience to just be around him. Era una gran experiencia estar ahí al lado de él, aprendiendo de él, learning from him. And I'm so glad and honored to be here today. I just want to share just something that the Lord placed in my heart. If you have your Bible, solamente les quiero decir algo que el Señor ha puesto en mi corazón. Si tienes tu Biblia, vamos a ir al libro de los Hechos. If you have your Bibles, let's go to the book of Acts. Amen. Book of Acts, chapter 5. Libro de los Hechos, capítulo 5. Verso 35, we're going to go to verse 35. When you have it, you can say amen.
Amen.
Amen. Amen. It says here, he said to them, men of Israel, be careful about what you're going to do to these men. Y luego dijo, varones israelitas, mirad por vosotros lo que vais a hacer respecto a estos hombres. 36 says, not long ago, Theudas rose up claiming to be somebody. And a group of about 400 men railed to him. He was killed, and his partisans were dispersed and came to nothing. Verso 36 dice, porque antes de estos días se levantó Teuda diciendo que era alguien, y este se unió a un número como de 400 hombres, pero él fue muerto y todos los que le obedecían fueron dispersados y reducidos a nada. Verse 37, after this man, Judas the Galilean, rose up in the days of the census and attracted a following. That man also perished and all his partisans were scattered. El verso 37 dice, después de este se levantó Judas el Galileo en los días del censo y llevó en pos de sí a mucho pueblo, pereció también él y todos los que lo obedecían fueron dispersados. Verse 38, and now I tell you, stay away from this man and leave them alone. For if this plan or this work is of man, it will be overthrown. El verso 37 dice, después de el verso 38, perdón, dice, y ahora os digo, apartaos de estos hombres y dejadlos, porque si este consejo, esta obra es de los hombres, se desvanecerá. Verse 39 says, but if it is of God, you will not be able to overthrow them. You may even be found fighting against God. So they were persuaded by him. El verso 39 dice, mas si es de Dios, no lo podráis destruir, no seas tal vez hallados luchando contra Dios. You may take a seat, se pueden sentar. I was reading this passage of scripture, and all of a sudden, these couple of verses began to jump out at me from the page. Estaba leyendo estos versículos, y el Señor comenzó a hablarme por medio de su palabra. And I began to read, and in this passage of scripture, the apostles or the disciples were arrested, and they were taken to the council of men. Ellos fueron arrestados y fueron llevados allá en el consejo de Gamaliel. And all of a sudden, these people are there, and they begin to discuss, and they begin to talk about these apostles. Y estos hombres comenzaron a hablar sobre los apóstoles. And then they start recapping on some people that have risen up and tried to establish their own kingdom. Y comenzaron a recordar a otros hombres que se levantaron a comenzar a establecer su reino. And then he begins to talk about Judas the Galilean. He begins to talk about Theudas, who rose up and began to gather many men with him. Comenzó a recordar de este hombre que se levantó y comenzó a agarrar a muchos hombres con él. And then he said he rose up. He gathered about 400. And he was killed. And the people that were following him were reduced to nothing. Él se levantó y se agarró muchos hombres. Y cuando murió él, también murió y pereció los que le estaban siguiendo. Then they say Judas, they talked about Judas, and they said Judas the Galilean, who rose up in the days, also attracted a following. He also attracted a group of people. Otro Judas que se levantó, él comenzó a agarrar a muchos hombres también. And then the Bible says that this man also died, and the people that followed him were scattered. La Biblia también dice que este hombre se levantó, pero cuando él murió, también murieron los que estaban siguiéndole. And then this man says, but if this is of God, talking about the apostles, pero dice, si esto es de Dios, no matter what man can do, no matter what man can possibly come up with, if this is of God, you will not find yourself fighting against man, you will find yourself fighting against God. And I come to tell somebody today, this church was not established by man, this church was not established by government, this church was Jesus Christ. This man tells us he rose up, he got his gathering, and he began began to establish his kingdom, and he fell away. He died, and also did the ones that were following him. Judas rose up out of nowhere, and he began to establish his own kingdom, and he died, and the ones that were following him also fell away. But one rose up, his name was Jesus. He died, but he